Hello, and welcome to the session in which we would look at financial ratios that deal specifically with the statement of cash flows. In the prior session, we learned how to prepare the statement of cash flows, and we talked about different parts of the statement of cash flows. Well, one purpose of the statement of cash flows is to help us make financial decision. How do we value a company? That's important. Looking at the statement of cash flows and using those ratios, it's going to give us better information about this company. Thus, better decision-making in terms of investing, not investing, lending money to this company, buying additional stocks, selling our position, so on and so forth. Specifically, we're going to be looking at three ratios: the current cash debt ratio, the cash debt ratio, and the free cash flow. And we're going to explain what each one of these ratios tells you as a user. So this is the purpose. One of the purpose of the cash flow statement is to give you additional information about the company. Now, this topic is covered on the CPA exam as well as in your intermediate accounting course. So it's very important that you understand this topic. Whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition to your CPA review course. I provide you alternative explanation, alternative resources. Your risk is 1 month of subscription. Your potential gain is passing the exam. I do have resources for other accounting courses as well. My CPA supplemental resources are aligned with your course directly, whether you are taking Roger, Wiley, Gleam, or Becker. They are aligned with that, so it's easy to go back and forth between my course and your CPA review course. I also have all the previously released AI CPA exam questions with detailed solution. If you have not connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Subscribe to my YouTube, like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So the first ratio we're going to look at is the current cash debt ratio. What is the current cash debt ratio? Well, it's going to measure our ability if we can pay off our short-term obligation, our current liabilities. So when we talk about current liabilities, we're looking at financial liquidity. Are we liquid enough? So this ratio measures liquidity. Liquidity talks about the short term. How is it computed? Well, it's computed by taking net cash provided by operating activities, and hopefully this is positive, not negative, dividing it by the average current liabilities. And the best way to illustrate this concept is to use some numbers. Let's assume $75,000 in net cash provided by operating activities to keep it also simple. We have $75,000 in the average liability. We have a ratio of 1 to 1 or just 1. A ratio of 1 to 1 is considered good. It means only from your operation, you can pay off all your liabilities. Now, companies don't pay off all their liabilities, but having the ability to pay off all your current liabilities, to be more specific, is a good thing. You are in good shape because you have financial liquidity. Now, the cash debt coverage it measures the ability to pay all liabilities without restoring to selling asset or restoring to outside finances. So now what we're doing, we're keeping the numerator the same, we're changing the denominator. And the denominator, we're going to say, how much can we cover of our total liabilities from operating cash? Well, this measure, looking at the long-term perspective of the company, because the company don't plan to pay off all its debt, right? And if it can pay off all its debt, they will not even borrow money in the first place if they cannot pay off all that debt from operating activities. So this measured the financial flexibility, how flexible the company in the long run. Okay, so it's computed by taking net cash provided by operating activities, and we're going to assume the number is 75, and average total liability, we're going to make the number 150. So this is, the ratio is 0.5. It means from operating activities, if we want to pay off all our liabilities, we can pay half of our liabilities. Again, no companies pay off all their liabilities, but we want to see a larger number. So rather than 0.5, we prefer 0.6, we prefer 0.7. Okay? Obviously, if it's 1 to 1, that's excellent. It means just from operating the business in one particular year, we can pay off all our liabilities. That would be great. The higher, the better. I just gave you this example. Again, ratios will have to be taken into perspective always. You have to compare it to prior period, competitors, so on and so forth. And the most interesting ratio is the free, not ratio, the most interesting indicator, something called free cash flow. And this is not really a ratio. This is basically a computation. Computation to figure out the discretionary cash. How much discretionary cash does the company have? What's discretionary cash? Well, that's a good thing. Discretionary means you can do anything with that cash, anything you would like to. This also measures your financial flexibility, like the cash debt coverage. You have flexibility to do things. Now, how do we measure this free cash flow? Well, we're going to take cash from operating activities. Hopefully it's positive. If it's negative, it's useless. And we're going to deduct from it any capital expenditure. Here, what we mean by capital expenditure is things we need to invest in the business to keep on going, to keep on operating. Think of them as required capital expenditure. Otherwise, the company will deteriorate. So let's assume our net operating cash is $75,000. And based on our need, we have $30,000 of capital expenditure for that particular year. Then we are required, not required, but in quote, we have to satisfy the shareholders, pay them some dividend. Otherwise, they would leave the company. We're going to pay them $10,000. If that's the case, we are left with $45,000. We call the $45,000 is the leftovers or free cash flow or discretionary cash. And this is good. You want this number to be positive. Basically, now we have this number of $45,000. We can do practically anything with it, anything we want to. Because from operating the company, we satisfy the capital expenditure, we satisfy the shareholders. What can we do now with this money? We can do many things. We can make additional investments, like buy other investments, discretionary investments. We can buy back treasury stock and even satisfy the shareholders better. We can pay off some debt. Why not? Now we can do anything with this cash. So when we invest in a company, when you invest in a company, you want to know what's their free cash flow. Because the free cash flow, this is for you. Basically, this is like the icing on the cake. This is what, you know, the investors can use. You can tell them to buy back treasury stock, pay off the debt. Let's remove the debt interest expense. So you want to have a positive free cash flow, not negative. In other words, if you have negative, it means from operating, you cannot satisfy the capital expenditure and the dividend. Now, at the end of this recording, again, I'm going to invite you, whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website and consider investing in your career. I do have resources for various accounting courses, for your CPA exam. The CPA exam is worth it.